Education is the passport to the future because tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. Hello friends, I am Grace Paul of grade 10 from Little Flower Public School, and I would like to gather your thoughts on the existing educational system of our motherland with its inherent merits and demerits. With the advancement of education, India has seen a great deal of development in the field of economy. Nowadays, we see that people are less unemployed or are even self-employed. There are several major good points about the educational system of India that we often overlook or neglect. So now, let's examine these pros of the education system of India and get a positive vibe about it. Reservation for the underprivileged. It is a great thing to know that the education system of India is the only example in the world to provide reservation of seats in schools, colleges, and universities. The reservation continues till date and is helping thousands of students from the so-called lower caste to get quality education and raise their economic and social status. Right to education. Education is upheld as a fundamental right following the Constitutional Act inserted in Article 21A of the Indian Constitution. Hence, free and compulsory education is provided to all children between the age group of 6 and 14 by the central and state governments and the union territory authorities. Focus on adult education. In its bid to eradicate illiteracy while providing opportunities for those who have crossed school and college ages, India has also a program for adult education. Very aware of it, might be never, because this is a unique feature of the Indian education system. While we all know that education plays a major part in shaping our lives, it is still a major problem in our country. We cannot deny the fact that the Indian government has been working towards reforming the existing educational model. There are still some areas where care has to be taken. So now let's examine the cons of the education system and find who is at fault. Rote learning. In a bid to score high, a student usually memorizes things rather than learning them, and after an exam is over, the student is completely blank about the subject. I feel schools must encourage to introduce conceptual learning so that students do not mug up what they have been taught. Evaluation system. Marks still play an important card in deciding a child's future, and this pressure to score high often makes them underperform. I feel the focus of evaluation should not be on a 3-hour exam. Rather, the focus should be shifted on the child's extracurricular activities, communication skills, and innate abilities. Unequal respect for subject. We still live in an education system where science stream topples the stream hierarchy. So true. Students are pushed to become machines, and subjects like commerce, arts, and communications are often looked down. Students should rather pursue what they like instead of creating a differentiation between subjects. Now that we know the pros and cons of the Indian education system, we can guess who is responsible for the plight and who deserves applauses. Whatever it may be, it requires efforts from all teachers, parents, students, and the government to bring about a sea change in the Indian education system, a change that sees pros on the rise and cons on the decline. Thank you.